Hello friends, I hope you all are doing well. Welcome back to your channel Ashish Webcast. My name is Ashish Pal. In today's video, we will learn how to set up group managed service account or a gMSA. So without any further delay, let's start this video. But before that, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel Ashish Webcast and also watch my other videos. The link will be given in the description box of this video. So let's start this video now. So let's first understand why we need a group managed service account. So earlier we used to have service accounts to manage any application or services in our infrastructure. These service accounts were basically a user account with attribute password never expires set to true. The issue with these service accounts was that we need to manage the password, we need to rotate the password, and also we need to register SPN to identify the services running for these service accounts. So to overcome all these challenges, Microsoft has introduced managed service accounts. So these managed service accounts, we need not to manage the password or rotate the password. This is done using the KDC. And the only limitation with this managed service account was that you can use these accounts on only one host or machine. So to overcome this limitation, Microsoft has introduced managed group managed service accounts, that is also called gMSA. So with gMSA, you need not to manage the password, you need not to rotate the password. Rotation of the password is managed using the KDC, and you can run the scheduled task as well with these gMSAs. So let's understand what is the requirement to use these gMSA. So first requirement is to, you need to have Windows Server 2012 or higher forest level. Second, the member servers on which you want to use this gMSA, they should be running on the Windows Server 2012 or higher. And you should have 64-bit architecture to run PowerShell to manage these gMSAs. So with this knowledge, let's understand what is our correct infrastructure and how we will be creating this gMSA. So we have a single forest, single domain, ashishwebcast.com. We have one domain controller, that is DC1. We have one app server 01 where we will be using the gMSA, and we will create one test gMSA. So let's start the configuration part of the gMSA now. So let's open the PowerShell in elevated mode. So first thing to create a gMSA is to, you need to have a KDS root key, because KDS will be responsible to change, sorry, KDC will be responsible to rotate the password. So you need to have a KDS root key. So let's see if we have any KDS root key in our current environment. So for that, we need to run this command get-KDS root key. So you can see there is no output. That means we don't have any KDS root key right now. So we will create one KDS root key first. So for that, you can use this command. But the only issue is that if currently we use this command, we have to wait for another 10 hours so that this KDS root key is distributed to all the domain controllers. So to bypass this, we can do one thing, we can run this command, but it is recommended Please do not run this command in your production environment. In test environment, it is okay. So we will create one KDS root key. Now let's check whether we have the KDS root key or not. Yes, we have. And now we will create one gMSA. The name of the gMSA will be test gMSA. And the DNS hostname will be testgmsa.ashishwebcast.com. And the principal allowed to retrieve manage password. So what we have done, what we will do, we will create one group. So inside that groups, we will add whatever servers where we want to use this gMSA. So let's first create a security group. So let's create a group. I'll create it here. Name I have already chosen. Let's click on this. A group is created. Now what we will do, we will add the app server 01 into this security group. Let's go to members. Let's add a member. Select computers here so that it detects a computer account. Okay, now let's check. Okay, so we have added app server 01 into the member of this security group. So now we can run this command. And here you can add single machine as well. But the purpose of the gMSA is to, we can manage gMSA, this gMSA on multiple servers. So let's run this command to create the gMSA. Account is created. Let's go to add users and computers. So these, whenever you create a gMSA, it will be stored in the manage service accounts folder or OU. So here you can see that we have test gMSA created. You can also check if you want to check what members or what are the properties of this gMSA. So you can basically run this command. Okay, let's correct the name of the gMSA. Okay, so these are the properties, and you can see that we have added a security group over here. So a gMSA is created. Now we will switch to our app server 01 and try to install the gMSA over there. So now we are logged in on app server 01, where we want to install or use the gMSA which we have created right now. So let's first install this gMSA account on this server. Open PowerShell and we can use the command install -ad service account -identity name of the gMSA and $ within the quotes. Let's run this command. So this error you will see when you don't have the AD PowerShell module installed on this server. So let's try to install this module. Let's go to manage, click on add roles and features, expand this window, click on next, click on role based or feature based installation, click on next, click on next. And in features, let's search for remote server administration tool. It's here. Expand this. Expand role administration tools. Expand ADDS and ADLDS tools. And check this Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell. and click on next and install. It will take some time to install this partial module. And there's one more thing I would like to bring up. You can get another error when you try to install the gMSA. So this error usually occurs when you have added this server as the member of the security group which you have added on the principled allowed to retrieve password attribute in while creating the gMSA, and you have not rebooted the server, so server won't be able to check what groups it is part of. So it is recommended to restart the machine when you add any server part of any security group in the AD. So let's check for the module if it is installed. It is still installing. So now the Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell is installed on this server. Let's try to run the same command. So command is successfully run, and let's try to test if we have installed the service gMSA over here or not. It's test-ad service account hyphen identity, then the name of the gMSA and a dollar at the end, quotes. So if it shows true, that means you have successfully installed the gMSA, and now you can use it to run a service or any task scheduler. So with this, we have successfully created and installed the gMSA account. See you in our next video. Till there, bye and take care.